Take a look at this animation. This is a simple experiment that you can perform at home. In this animation, a chessboard is being brought in front of a mirror, and a king piece is placed on the chessboard. Now you will notice that as the king piece is moved on the chessboard, the image of the king piece on the mirror moves accordingly. If the king piece is brought to the front of the mirror, the image also moves to the front. And if the king piece is taken at the back of the chessboard, the image of the king piece is also moving back to the chessboard. So what do you think is happening? The image of the king is moving accordingly with the king on the other side of the mirror. So let us find out what is happening with another experiment. Here in this animation, we find a boy is standing in front of the mirror. Now you will notice that when the boy is walking towards the mirror, the image of the boy in the mirror is also walking towards the mirror. If you observe closely, you will see that if the boy takes two steps towards the mirror, the image also takes two steps towards the mirror. And if the boy takes two steps away from the mirror, the image also does the same. You will also notice that the distance of the boy from the mirror remains the same as the distance of the image of the boy from the mirror. And you can also see that the boy is standing upright and his image on the mirror is also upright. So what can we say are the properties of the image that is being formed on the mirror? Let us find out. We learn that the image that is being formed is erect. As we saw in the case of the chessboard, the king piece was erect and the image of the king was also erect. Similarly, we saw it in the case of the boy. We saw that the image is of the same size. The king that was placed on the chessboard had an image which was the same size as the king itself. Also, when the boy stood in front of the mirror, the image of the boy was the same size as that of the boy. And lastly, the distance of the object from the mirror is equal to the distance of the image from the mirror. Again, we saw this in both cases. In case of the king, as we were moving the king on the chessboard, the image of the king was moving accordingly. That is, if we moved the king to the back of the chessboard, the image of the king also moved to the back of the chessboard. Even in the case of a boy, we found when the boy took two steps towards the mirror, the image of the boy also took two steps towards the mirror. Likewise, when the boy took two steps backward from the mirror, the image also took two steps backwards. Now notice this animation closely. Here you find that the boy is raising his right hand up. Now if you look at the image of the boy, you will notice that the image is raising up his left hand. So why do you think this is happening? That the boy is raising his right hand and the image is raising his left hand? Here you notice that there is an apparent left to right reversal. So what is this left-right reversal called? This left-right reversal is known as lateral inversion. What is lateral inversion? Here lateral means sideways and inversion means reversal. So the apparent left and right reversal of the image formed on the mirror when compared with the object is known as lateral inversion. In the case of the boy standing in front of the mirror, we saw that when the boy raised up his right hand, the image raised up its left hand. So there was a left and right reversal. This reversal is known as lateral inversion. Now, have you ever wondered if lateral inversion is employed or used anywhere. If you have ever noticed an ambulance, you will have seen that the letters on the ambulance are written in a reverse manner, somewhat like this. Do you know the reason why ambulance is written like this on the body of the ambulance? The reason is, when the driver of a car sits in the car and sees from his rearview mirror, due to lateral inversion, he will be able to view this writing in a proper manner. Due to this, he will be able to understand that an ambulance is coming from behind, and he will be able to make way for the ambulance. If the word ambulance was written originally like this, then after reflection, it would have appeared like this. And for the driver in the car, it would have been very difficult to make out what is written. So, by writing ambulance like this, lateral inversion is employed to make it easier for drivers in their cars to read the writing better. So, taking a quick recap, what did we learn? We learned that the image formed on a plane mirror by an object has certain properties. What are those properties? The image formed is erect and upright. The image formed is the same size as that of the object. And the distance of the object from the mirror is the same as the distance of the image from the mirror. We also learned that when an object is placed in front of a mirror, the reflection undergoes lateral inversion. What is lateral inversion? The apparent left-right reversal of the image is known as lateral inversion. In the case of the animation, we saw that when the boy was raising his right hand up, the image was raising up its left hand. We also saw how lateral inversion is used by humans in order to read ambulance in a better manner, to make it more convenient for the drivers driving their cars on the roads.